Everywhere I go, I see his face. I just really miss him.
I don't think Tony would have done what he did if he didn't know that you were going to be here after he was gone.
Spider-Man Far From Home, the first iteration movie after the events of the snap, but on this movie they call it the blip. It stars Tom Holland, the Cussmaster himself, Samuel L. Jackson, Jake Gyllenhaal, and the girl from Euphoria, Zadonna, and we're going to talk about it right now, but first. On this channel, we always put on our plus seven glasses of Marvel movie review and sexy as hell because we're working on skilling our craft, bringing you a more informed YouTube experience, giving you the life game and let you know if you should go see the movie. Subscribe to this channel, turn on notifications so when I drop videos, you get them. I want to help you guys understand if this is going to be worth your buy or not, considering I have the same feeling I had maybe a year ago after Infinity War. I was so hyped and so pumped for that movie and I was riding a high. No matter what Marvel put out after that, I didn't have the same anticipation. Same feeling with this movie, Far From Home, with Spider-Man. I didn't have that same umph for it because I had been on a roller coaster ride with Endgame. Having said that, let's start with what's talking about good in this movie. First of all, the CGI in this movie is some of the best Marvel has done. They have worked hard to improve upon their CGI year to year to year. So if you've been frustrated with CGI in a movie from Marvel, you're gonna go to this movie and have a good time. They have something in this movie called the Elementals, and that CGI on those things are outstanding. You'll be pleased with the CGI. The next thing that is just outstanding, Jake Gyllenhaal, ladies and gentlemen, a well-established actor, can do anything. His role as Mysterio in this movie is just outstanding. He's weird. He's an anti-hero. He has great dialogue. He shifts from feeling this way to feeling another way. I mean, you cannot take your eyes off him. And I've always said a great villain is what really, really makes the movie good, because it pushes the superhero, it pushes his boundaries, it makes him have to be a better character. Having said that, that's about all the good I'm gonna say about the movie. I will say they had some comedy. It was okay. I mean, the comedy wasn't bad, don't get me wrong, but it was kind of your slapstick comedy. And this movie, just like the last Spider-Man, kind of reminds you of an after-school medley with teens or a teen romance with the backdrop of superheroes. They got a lot of that. And the pacing in the very beginning of this movie was slow for me because they spent like 30 minutes of kids having dialogue. Tom Holland, he's chasing MJ, which I like MJ. I like the girl, she's from Euphoria playing MJ in this movie. I like their dialogue, but it just has that slow feel, that high school melody. And they take that high school melody and then they send them international. So it's got kind of that part. But once it gets beyond that part, they've got some pretty good action scenes. Still don't see a lot of web slinging from Tom Holland. I mean, decent web slinging, but not a lot that you would like to see from Spider-Man. And my issues with Tom Holland is that he's still struggling to be Spider-Man. As you remember in Infinity War, what did Iron Man call Spider-Man? He called him Spider-Ling. And that's an issue that Tom Holland has been having since the last movie to this one. He's struggling to be Spider-Man versus Spider-Boy. And with carrying that narrative, it brings it into this movie, and that's still another struggle. He's always kind of seeming like he's looking for help when, dude, you have been through Infinity War. It's time for you to step up and be Spider-Man. But having said that, I like Samuel L. Jackson in the movie. I like Maria Hill in the movie. I really, really like the lady that plays Maria Hill. She does a good job. And Marissa Tomei plays his aunt. And the young people might not know about her, but she was in A Different World. And she seems to look better and better as the years progress. And she's an established actor as well. One thing that you're going to want to stay for that hasn't been worth your time in the past, they have a post-credit scene. Then they have a final post-credit scene. And both of these post-credit scenes mean something this time. It's not kind of like some of the last couple of movies you've seen where they didn't have any big stakes or anything going forward in the future for the MCU, these post-credit scenes are gonna leave you like, oh man. So make sure you stay for all of the post-credit scenes. Having said all that, should you stream this movie or beam it? It's just gonna depend upon if you are a comic book fan, whether you like the comic books, the cartoon, or the MCU, or you have kids that really, really love Spider-Man. If you fit any of those, you go see the movie because it is okay. It's not a bad movie. It's a palate cleanser, and they do a lot of letting you know things that happen after the snap. They're going to tell you what happened to those high school kids after the snap. They're going to tie in some other things that happened after the snap. So if you fit in that narrative, go see it. But if you're just a novel fan of the MCU, a novel fan of action, then I'm going to tell you, you can wait. I will give this movie, Spider-Man Far From Home, a 6.5. That's going to do it for this video. Don't forget to like my video. Please comment, subscribe, go get yourself a life game. Let me know if you saw the movie. How did you feel about it? And what do you think of my review? Did I hit the points for those of you that seen it that made sense for you? And if I didn't, let me know how you feel. And until that next sexy as hell Marvel movie review, I'll see you.